Welcome to OreoOlive.com. I'm your host, Scholar, and today we're going to review one of the most famous movies of Black royalty before Black Panther. And yes, you know what movie I'm referring to. I'm referring to it being around and before 1988, when an African prince sets his heart to visit America to find his wife. Now, take a guess. I give you a clue. It marks over about 30-year anniversary. Now, if you ask anyone from the Black community what were some of their top movies that they watched growing up as a kid, I'm willing to bet you'll hear Friday, starring Ice Cube and Chris Tucker, as well as Boys in the Hood as well, and of course, our all-time favorite, Coming to America. Now, Coming to America aired in about 1988 with actors, as we know, from Eddie Murphy, Arsenio Hall, James Earl Jones, Garcia Beavis, John Amos, Madge Sinclair, Cherie Headley, and many more actors. Now, as we know, Coming to America has been at the heart of the Black community as one of the all-time favorite movies. Now, the movie most definitely shows a lot of positive images of African royalty ruling in the nation of Zamunda. And as we know, Prince Hakeem, who's played by Eddie Murphy, as we know he plays many, you know, other characters in the film, woke up on his 21st birthday to being pampered and showered with gifts at the royal palace. Now, leading to his father also includes setting him up with Princess Imani Easy, who's played by Vanessa Bell Calloway, of course. Now, after Princess Imani and Hakeem talked into the private room about what her likes were, her replies were, "Whatever you like," and we all know that line. Now, Hakeem looks into the camera, and then he asks her to bark like a dog and hop on one foot, and she hops on one leg out of the room. Now, keep that in mind. From the moment Hakeem sets his mind that he must travel to Queens, New York, to find his wife with his aide, Simi, who's played by Arsenio Hall. Now, keep in mind that the two men that Hakeem gave a brown bag to, was full of money, were homeless, and they was on that walk on the pier, and the same two guys were also from the movie Trading Places. Now, while living well below his means to hide his wealth, to find his true love, he falls in love with Lisa McDowell, who's played by Cherie Headley, of course. Now, there were different twists and turns into the film as well, but Hakeem makes his way back to Africa to find out that his father had moved forward in an arranged marriage for him. Now, Hakeem stands at the royal altar. He looks up to see his love, Lisa McDowell. Now, if we go from 1988 and fast forward to 2021, Coming to America 2 stars a heavy list of new actors and actresses. And when you're looking at the film, you notice you have Wesley Snipes, you have Leslie Jones, Tiana Taylor, Rotimi, Michael Blackson, Tracy Morgan, Rick Ross as well, and you have Linnell and a list of new faces throughout the entire film. Now, Hakeem's heir to the throne was supposed to be his eldest daughter, Mika, played by Kiki Layne. Now, however, King Joffrey Joffa shared a secret with Hakeem as he was resting on his bed about his son in America. Now, once again, Hakeem and Simi make their way on a royal jet back to Queens to find out that he has a son. Now, the movie is filled with many waves of laughter and music videos and a lot of dances that are currently in the 21st century, of course. But Hakeem sets his son up for a wedding and he quickly discovers his new bride catches his eye. Now, the similarity in both films have similar lines that we can call, that we can remember. Now, General Izzy, played by Wesley Snipes, he has a daughter who repeats the same behavior as "whatever you like," which quickly turns off Prince LaBelle. Now, after a brisk walk in the garden, he shared a kiss with Marambi, who's played by Nonzami Babatha, and he realizes that whom he wants to marry her instead. Now, Prince LaBelle and Marambi leave Zamunda. They return all the way back to America to jump the broom, only to find out that the same pastor who Arsenio Hall played officiated the wedding ceremony. And then Akeem comes busting into the door. He stops the wedding. He realizes his son is following his heart and what he did back with Lisa. And then from that wedding, Akeem makes up his mind by allowing Prince Lavelle to be an ambassador in America. And he rightfully changes the rules in Zamunda to let Mika be the heir to the throne. Now, that's definitely a twist. Now, if you move forward from that, we're going to get into the fun facts. Now, the same two men, as I mentioned before, who were on that pier when him and Lisa were walking that he gave that bag of money to, became very wealthy. They passed a company down to their nephew, who was the interviewer of a job that Lavelle was interviewing for. Now, back in the club, we knew that Simi was talking to a lot of the ladies, but we had no clue that Akeem kind of had plans of his own. Now, it was high throughout the movie to see familiar faces such as Paul Bates, She's Your Queen to Be, Louis Anderson, who was now running the McDowell's in Zamunda, which was very hilarious because, as he mentioned, they were putting their toppings on the bottom rather than the top, kind of copying off the Blizzard or the McFlurry from McDonald's. But Wesley Snipes and Tiana Taylor, they were definitely great picks for their roles, but it was funny how Vanessa Bell Calloway was still hopping from Sunday, June the 26th of 1988 to Friday, December the 18th of 2020. So she hopped for 11,863 days and 32 years and 5 months. And now that's a little bit too much, but it's a little bit trivial too. Now, even to the point that her golden bracelets on her wrist had broken off, and that was just quite funny. Now, one other funny scene is when James Earl Jones was awoke upright in the casket sitting on the throne as he was listening to his tribute by Morgan Freeman and Gladys Knight singing Midnight Train to Georgia, and even in Vogue and Salt and Pepper and DeVito making their appearances in the film as well. So that was really awesome. Now, finally, King Jaffa looks over, he tells Akeem he's leaving, and he just quietly falls into a restful state. Now, the film is a must. You have to check it out. So definitely stay a bit at the end for the credits, because you will see John Legend singing at the end. Now, I immediately thought about Jamie Foxx taking him on that challenge, because they're both are extremely talented singers. Now, it was great as well through some research that I found out that the movie was filmed, a portion of it was filmed at Rick Ross Fayetteville Estates out in Atlanta and also in Tyler Perry Studios. So a shout out to them for having the resources to add to this wonderful project. Now the films such as Bad Boys for Life and also shared a portion of the Tyler Perry Studios for filming. So the crews got to meet each other. But at this moment, it's rare to have a movie when you almost have the same cast for nearly 32 years. So if you guys have not checked out the film, definitely check it out. I just wanted to give you my take and a little review on it from what I seen in the film, but it was definitely hilarious. It was definitely needed, especially during this time that we're in right now, being stuck in the house and kind of not really out in public as much, but it's definitely brought a lot of laughter and I'm sure a lot of people enjoyed the film. So you guys go out there and check it out. If you got Amazon Prime, it's actually free. So I'll leave it to you to get you some popcorn and get you a little snack together and watch the film. Catch you guys later.